I grew up in the 1990s, the turn of the century. It was a magical time for the nascent web, a gloriously dithered experience filled with at least 256 colors, which really is all you need. As a punk teen, I was cranking out blink tags on my gorgeous Aptiva at home, as well as the fancy Macs that they had in the AV room at school. Flash forward a few decades, and my vintage computer-adjacent band, the Stop Bits, needs a website to advertise our upcoming shows. Naturally, I wanted it to fit in with the websites that I was making as a kid. But I still wanted it to be modern enough to work with feed readers, and it'd be nice to be able to edit posts with Markdown instead of AOLPress. In today's episode, I'll walk you through how I set up a 90s-style website using Eleventy, my favorite modern static site generator. Greetings and welcome to another exciting episode of Veronica Explains. I'm Veronica, and I love the flexibility of a static site generator. I'm going to quickly explain what that means, since YouTube analytics tell me that at least some of you are younger than me, and you might benefit from a minute of backstory. Okay, 60 seconds on the clock, and it's explaining time now. Before the internet was just four websites on people's phones, we used to have to spin up a server and host the content that your browser would show you. And generally speaking, that content can either be static files, like pictures and marked up text, or it can be created dynamically in real time as you visit the page. Now, in that latter case, you typically see some sort of database involved, and the web server itself usually has to do a lot more work. If you've ever spun up a WordPress or a Drupal site, or you're hosting a site on Wix or Squarespace, not sponsored, you're typically dealing with a dynamic type of site, and they can feel a bit sluggish at times. Now, it's totally possible to optimize one of those dynamic sites to make it snappier, but it takes some amount of specialized labor, and a lot of folks, for a myriad of reasons, just don't put in that effort. Static sites, on the other hand, are usually a lot simpler to serve, since they're more or less just fixed text and image files. Okay, that wasn't so bad. I tend to prefer deploying static sites for personal projects like this one, since they're a bit easier to serve. And while it's entirely possible to write a static site with pure HTML and CSS, 100% from scratch, a lot of us here in the roaring 2K20s choose to use a static site generator, which is a program that runs on the developer's machine and converts Markdown files that are stored in a folder into a fully fleshed out static website. There's no shortage of great static site generators, but I prefer Eleventy for its flexibility with data structures and template languages. Eleventy is written in JavaScript and distributed via NPM. But keep in mind that the Eleventy JavaScript only runs on your development machine, and you aren't required to use or host JavaScript in your final site at all. Plus, it's got an awesome community behind it, and any time I've ever had a question, it's been trivial to get answers from a bunch of friendly people. Now, I'm not going to go rehash their documentation, which is stunning, by the way, but you can learn more for yourself at 11ty.dev. And if you want me to pivot into web dev tutorials and talking about why I hate jQuery, as always, make sure to leave me a comment. Last year, I recreated my very first web dev environment, which was AOLPress on Windows 95, and then managed to make up a very basic static page for my band. AOLPress was a web authoring tool from America Online, the original too-big-to-fail walled garden of the early web. I used AOLPress as a kid to create punky web content for me and my friends, and it's a lot of fun to mess around with today. Of course, the HTML it outputs is far from standards compliant nowadays, and there's absolutely no CSS to be spoken of here. It was trivial to set up Apache and serve these pages after copying it off of my 486. I did make sure to add alt tags for the images and some metadata properties in order to make it easier to share on modern social media. And because it's period appropriate, it loads just fine on hardware from the 1990s, like my trusty PowerMac 9600. My high school had a few computers just like this, and I used them in my AV classes to take my very first steps into media production. Now, this AOLPress site would be enough, but I wanted to add a few more modern touches. Primarily a newsreader feed and the ability to have pretty links for individual posts, which should make social sharing a bit easier. See, with all the AI slop mucking up search results, I personally think it's going to be more important than ever to make pages a bit easier to share in our social networks and our group chats. And Eleventy is flexible enough to adapt even this monstrosity to a modern workflow. I started with the official Eleventy base blog starter repo, which includes just about everything you need to start a blog right away, with a minimal amount of effort. The starter uses the Nunjux templating engine, which is familiar to me as somebody who worked with Django and Flask before. But Eleventy is flexible enough to work with a ton of different template concepts, so you really aren't limited here. The base layout is located in the _includes/layouts subdirectory, and I started by removing the one JavaScript module, a small thing which generates heading anchors on page load. I also removed all the CSS. Now, JavaScript is nice for modern sites, and I adore clean, reliable, modern CSS, but I want this site to work on ancient computers, like the kind I was using in high school. If your website is targeting computers made in the last 15 years, you should probably skip that step. Then I slowly rearranged the base template into something which resembled the website that I made earlier with AOLPress. This involves a lot of old-school defining of colors inside of tags, which is not a good idea if you aren't targeting devices and browsers from the last millennium. It was a lot of futzing, and rather than give you a play-by-play, I've shared the code over on my Codeberg for anyone who wants to take a peek. Luckily, while I was futzing with all of this and trying to get the site to look just like I wanted, Eleventy has the option to automatically build the site and serve it locally in real time with the handy-dandy npx @11ty/eleventy-serve command. The template, by default, watches for pages and posts in a directory called content, and images and other static files are passed through from the public directory. And this is all very customizable from the eleventy.config.js file. When Eleventy runs, Markdown and HTML files are basically parsed through the Nunjux templates and converted into pure HTML. And those pages, along with your images, atom feeds, and other style elements, all gets outputted into the _site directory. From there, you can put it wherever you want it. Again, this isn't a web dev tutorial, so I'm not going to cover every possible option here, but Eleventy is so flexible and easy to deploy that you almost don't even need the docs. That said, it's rare to have an open source project with such stellar documentation as Eleventy has. This is so cleanly documented, and Zach Leatherman, the creator/maintainer of the project, does a fantastic job of fostering a positive community. The starter blog project defaults to placing posts in the /content/blog directory. Basically, you just create a Markdown file, and the name of the file becomes the short URL of the blog post. Then you can add a bit of front matter, which translates into information that Eleventy can use throughout your templates. Here, I use the description in the News from the Band section to give little previews of each post. When I save the markdown file and then run the npx command, Eleventy takes that markdown, applies it to all of the project's files, and then basically recompiles the website, including an atom feed, archive pages, and the front page. For me, personally, this is a lot easier than WordPress. I mean, this whole workflow can be set up with a few bash aliases, and now publishing to my website is easier than it's ever been before. And while I'm using Apache to serve this, this setup can easily be adapted to GitHub Pages or an object storage provider or some sort of Docker thing. You got options. Which is more than I can say for a lot of complex modern frameworks. For years, I've used WordPress, which is a pain to containerize, not to mention all the security problems, the time I've wasted chasing optimization, and the corporate-driven leadership with a bad case of founder syndrome. So much of the modern web introduces layer after layer of complexity. But it really doesn't have to be this way. I mean, I was able to spin up the Eleventy version of this beast in like a day. And I didn't even have to swallow my pride and learn any React. I feel like so much of the modern web is solving problems by introducing new problems. And while admittedly things are a bit more complex than they were like 3 decades ago, I feel like we can make better websites by, you know, just making better websites. I didn't include oodles of tracking code in the stopbits.net because I don't have to. The web server does a fine enough job of telling me when I have traffic. And if I really need more information, there's reasonable analytics software that won't eat into your experience. I didn't need to figure out your screen size, because laying out content one block at a time looks fine. I avoided a database, so the server has to do a lot less work. And best of all, I'm in control of it. If the Eleventy project dies, which I doubt it will, but if it does, I can just switch to something else. Or I can roll my own static site generator in COBOL. I probably won't roll my own static site generator in COBOL. When we host ourselves, we reassert a sliver of control in this chaotic space. And when we choose leaner, meaner options like Eleventy or any other static site generator, we reduce the friction for everyone and make the web a little bit nicer, like it used to be. Maybe you're nostalgic for the old web, or you're just sick of the current web. And if that's you, maybe carving out your own little popsicle stand on the information superhighway will help you feel a bit better. I know I do. To mention, the Stopbits will be performing live at VCF Southeast in Atlanta on June 21st, 2025. And you can find out more at our website, thestopbits.net.